Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into Him who is the head, into Christ.
Hi. In 2011, the St. Louis Cardinals, who happened to be my favorite baseball team, were not playing very well. But then in the last 2 months of the season, they got very hot, and it was hard to beat them. They played so well that even though they didn't win their division, they had the best record of all of the second place teams in the National League, which meant they were a wild card and they got to go to the playoffs. It's a wonder they made the playoffs, but they just wouldn't give up. So they made it through the playoffs. Wasn't easy, but they didn't give up, and they wound up in the World Series against the Texas Rangers. In Game 6, Texas had a 3-2 lead against the Cardinals. Game 6 is what ESPN calls the greatest baseball game ever played. Why? Because it's a story of a team that just refused to give up. It wasn't the greatest game ever played because it was just perfectly well executed. It wasn't. Both teams made mistakes. They made errors. But in the 9th inning, Texas had a 2-run lead, and the Cardinals had 2 outs, and the batter had 2 strikes, which meant they were 1 strike away from losing the World Series. But wouldn't you know it, they put some hits together, got a couple of runs, and tied the game. So that meant it went into extra innings. Well, in the top of the 10th inning, Texas scored 2 runs, looked like they were going to win the World Series. They go to the bottom of the 10th inning, the Cardinals are down 2 runs. Once again, they have 2 men out, and the batter has 2 strikes. So for the second time in 2 innings, they are 1 strike away from losing the World Series. Guess what? They put some hits together and they tie it again. At which point, Fox's broadcaster, Joe Buck, stated a line that will forever exist in the folklore of baseball broadcasting. He just said, "They just won't go away." They weren't going to give up. So a little bit later, they hit a home run, win Game 6, and go on to win Game 7. It was quite an up and down year for them, but they just wouldn't give up. And I guess outside of Jesus, if I think of someone who just wouldn't give up, I think of the Apostle Paul. We've talked before about how he was shipwrecked, afflicted with disease, persecutions, heartbrokenness as he was concerned for fellow Christians. But then he had his successes, and it seemed like everything was up and down, but he just wouldn't give up. In fact, as he is meeting with King Agrippa, he offers this following statement in Acts chapter 26 and verse 22. He says, "To this day I have had the help that comes from God, and so I stand here testifying to both small and great, saying nothing but what the prophet and Moses said would come to pass." And so all through his journey that he's telling Agrippa about and this message that he's proclaiming, he's saying this has come from God. It's not all on him. He hasn't given up because it's from God. But now I want you to focus on the final verse in all of the book of Acts. Think of Luke and Acts as a 2-volume set by the same author, because really that's what they are. You've got the gospel in Luke and then the response by the church, empowered by the Holy Spirit in Acts. But there's an interesting statement made about Paul. Now, in this situation, Paul's experiencing another trial. He's under house arrest. He knows he's going to be put to death before too much longer. And yet, we see this final statement. This is Acts chapter 28. And I'm going to be reading verses 30 and 31. "He lived there 2 whole years at his own expense and welcomed all who came to him, proclaiming the kingdom of God and teaching about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance." That phrase, "and without hindrance," is just one word in the Greek. It just means unhindered. Think about this. You've got this 2-volume set of the greatest story ever told. You might be tempted to interpret these last 2 verses as kind of a trailing off. because we know what's going to happen to Paul. I tend to think of these last two verses as a dramatic explanation point. It's not, and Paul went on unhindered. It's like he was unhindered. He was not going to stop. You know, that's how we need to be. That's how we really must be in times like this. It's easy to get discouraged. We miss each other. The economic news isn't great right now. There are still people sick. But we must go on unhindered. And we will. Just like Paul, by the power of God, we will refuse to give up. We're not going to go away because we love God. And he's never given up on us, so we're not going to give up on him. And we move forward unhindered. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the example of Paul in teaching us how we too can be unhindered. Help us to be bold, to never give up, to know that ultimately this is your work, but it's your work in us. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thanks a lot. We'll see you next time. God bless.